We will start off with mapping. Before we dive deep into how to do mapping with a robot using ROS, we will look at some theory to help you understand what's happening. As we have seen, a map is absolutely mandatory to navigation. But how do we get a map? In some cases, we can just use a pre-existing map. However, there are different types of maps, and it's not always suitable for our application. Let's look at an example. I'm in Amsterdam, and I want to go visit some friends. The first option I have is to take the subway. I found this map online. On this map, I can see different stations and how they are connected. On another website, I found this map. So, which one do I use now? Well, it doesn't really matter. They both contain the same information. The only thing I care about when I'm using the subway is the stations and their connections. How it's exactly drawn on a piece of paper is none of my concern. This is called a topological representation. It's basically a graph. I start off at the blue station and I want to go to the red one. The geometric scale does not need to be accurate. I could have also drawn it like this. Both representations are equally valid. Because we don't need to worry about scale and where each station exactly is, this representation is lightweight. It does not need much space to be stored. It's also useful for path planning. This representation seems very useful, but what if I'm not going to take the subway? I'm going to drive myself. Is this representation enough? Well, in such a case, a metric representation will be more useful. This representation uses precise coordinates. For example, longitude and latitude are used to determine every place on Earth. Because this method needs to be so accurate and precise, it's pretty sensitive to noise. Now we have two representations, the topological representation, and which is basically a graph, and a metric representation, which is a very detailed map of the environment. In a lot of applications, we will not have a pre-existing map. In that case, we will have to create a map ourselves, using the robot, of course. The process of creating a map is called mapping. Let's take a look at an example. Right here, we have a mobile robot. I have chosen a different robot than a TurtleBot to show you that the concepts are the same. We have Gazebo on the right-hand side, and Arvis on the left-hand side. We will drive the robot around, and as we go, the map will be created of this environment. We see that as we move, the map is being built. This process is called simultaneous localization and mapping. That means the robot is building a map while keeping track of its own position.